Sarah Omar. Should you should be
Hi.
able. Hi,
Do you
Sarah.
want me to share the presentation from my side, or you will share it?
All right, she'll share it for you,
Yeah,
yeah?
here goes. Yeah, I'm lucky.
All right, thank you very much. Don't forget, you
Okay.
got 10 minutes, eh?
Yeah, sure. Okay. So
All
thank you
right,
so
thank you
much.
very
Good
much.
morning, everyone. Before I get started, I just want to tell you that I'm currently based in the Middle East. However, South Africa is my second home because this is where I grew up. So I'm very excited about this. So today I'm talking about biomimicry, specifically in brain targeting, because this is how we're going to use it. And I'm going to talk to you about what's biomimicry and why is it important for brain targeting and so. So how can I move the slides? Okay, so we will talk about challenges facing brain drug delivery systems in the brain, because most of the drugs that we take cannot reach the brain, or they don't reach effectively to the brain. And then we will talk about other researchers, how they came up with different approaches to target the brain or to deliver drugs to the brain. And then we'll talk about our preparation or our research, how we use this nano technology and the biomimicry systems to target the brain. And we'll talk a little bit about the in vivo results since we tested them on animal models. So first thing, if you thought about if you can bring this the animation, if you can have another clip, please. Yes. So if you thought about if you imagine yourself like a hydrophilic drug and you went into a biological body or a human body, so the first thing you will meet is that you will face fast elimination. The body will get rid of you quickly since you're water soluble, so it's a kind of, to wash it out quickly. It won't stay there for a long time. The second thing is that there's no selectivity to the brain, which means that if you're taking Alzheimer's drug or anti-Alzheimer's drug, you're trying to treat Alzheimer's, what will happen is that the drug will roam all over the body. It will not only go to the brain, it will go to your kidneys, it will go to the liver, it will go everywhere. And that's where we end up with maximized toxicity of the drug, because you don't want your Parkinson's drug to go to the liver or to the kidneys. And the minimized efficacy, since not all the 100% of the drug reaches the brain. And all this together, this is like the main challenges for water-soluble drugs. However, when we talk about the brain specifically, it comes with a highly securing system around the brain, which is the blood-brain barrier. And it's very selective. It doesn't let anyone there. It only allows certain micronutrients. So if you can see, this is like the drug. It's just roaming all around the body instead of just going directly to the brain. If you can see in the coming slide, the drug in the blood vessel trying to go to the blood-brain barrier, it's blocked, and it must be not too highly charged, not too large, it must be too small, and not highly hydrophilic. And even when it's hydrophobic or it's lipid soluble, it must be small. It must not be highly charged again. So it's a kind of little bit, it's very challenging, and it's very restricted for a lot of nutrients or a lot of drugs to go into the brain easily. So here, most of the researchers, or so far the approaches that are used for brain targeting, they either they come up with like platforms or delivery systems that use one of these approaches to reach the brain. So for the brain absorption, it's like the drug, it's inside the platform. If you can imagine the platform, or it's like a vehicle or like a carrier for the drug. And then this platform is kind of coated with protein. So it's like we're tricking the brain so that it can take the drug without recognizing it. Another approach is the blood-brain barrier interaction. So sometimes even it's done physically. They kind of apply electric, of course, like very light electric waves, so to change that highly closed securing system around the brain, by modifying the molecules into hydrophobic ones, by prolonging the blood circulation. This is a new approach. which they found that if you have your drug circulating for a long time in the body, you will have like a higher chance that it would come across. It will meet the blood brain barrier for so many times, so it's kind of increasing its chance, but still it needs to be to have, you know, the access, or it needs to be eligible to pass the blood brain barrier. So for this is like the main approaches that are currently used in the brain targeting. So for our research, if you can bring the main slide, please. This is to target the blood in the brain. So for our approach, we came up with the method that it's biomimicry. So basically, if we can go to the next slide and then come back here. The next one. So biomimicry, as defined by nature science, it's mainly an interdisciplinary field. But what I want to emphasize here on is that it uses models from nature, so that we can resemble biological processes. It's a kind of we see what happens really inside the body, what kind of things are really taken up by the brain, and then we resemble this in the lab, so that we can, it's a way to trick the brain so that it can take the drugs. Can we have the previous slide, please? Yes, thank you so much. So here, our approach, we decided to, this is down here at the bottom of the slide, is rivastigmine. This is a hydrophilic cationic drug that is used for Alzheimer's disease. This drug is currently sold in the market as oral tablets for Alzheimer's disease. The normal thing with this drug is that when patients take the drug, only 30% of this drug reaches the brain. So the other 70% go harming the kidneys, the liver, everywhere, okay? So we're going to take this drug now, and we're going to hide it inside a platform that is composed of several things. One of them here on the upper right, the PLGA, this is a polymer that is biodegradable. So this is giving stability so that we can have our platform inside the body for a long time. And then we coat this PLGA with phospholipids. The phospholipids are basically the kind of lipids that the blood-brain barrier and other cells in the body are made up of, okay? And then we're going to add an outer layer on top of all this, which is composed of sodium chelate, which is a biological surfactant. Surfactant is basically the thing that helps to dissolve lipids, along with dextrin, and we conjugated here the dextrin with sodium chelate. So all this together, we're gonna develop our platform so that we can deliver this hydrophilic drug. And when it's cationic, it's even more challenging. Okay, so can we move two slides? Yes, thank you. So that's what we did. Here, the outer shell here, it's the yellow one, it's the phospholipids, and inside here, the drug molecules with the PLGA polymer, and of course the dextrin with the sodium chelate. This is like the outer most shell, and of course all this together is where we prepared it in a small size from 100 nanometers to 150 nanometers. This variation in size is not only in one formula, because we've done a lot of formulas, so it's kind of it's like I know this variation is very large. Okay, and what we found that this platform showed low toxicity and tunable release profile, which means that we can by adding more lipids, we can control the release of the drug that is not instantly released or released on a long time and so on. So can we move, please? This is the method of preparation here. We were adding basically the PLGA with
one,
the-
One
with
minute
the,
left.
Okay, so I don't need to go through the preparation. If we can just, can we move the slide, please? And in the view results, can we? Yeah, so as you can see here, the elimination time, the last one on the table, the elimination time here of the this one, the column in the middle, it's the longer, so it's not eliminated quickly. This is after the administration of this platform with the drug. Of course, the drug was the fastest one to get eliminated. Can we go through the next one, please? Yes. Here in the brain, as you can see, the highest one was that because we tried the platform with this outer layer, and one of them was without, it was only with the Levitt shell. The Levitt shell was higher than the solution. However, the one coated with all the polymers and the lipids was the one that with the highest targeting efficiency in the brain. Can we get the next slide, please? Again, here the targeting efficiency was 10 times higher than the drug solution, and the platform without the dextrane polymer and the biological surfactants. Can we move? To sum up, so biomimicry, it's basically, as we said, it's, you know, we're trying to simulate the nature so that we can develop something or develop a unique architecture that can target the brain. And here it worked out well for this hydrophilic drug, which is giving a promising treatment for Alzheimer's disease, which is a really devastating disease. This is, as I mentioned, it gave a long circulation platform, and it was selective to the brain.
Thank you very much, Sarah. Your time is up now.
Yeah, I'm done.
Yeah, I've also given you some few seconds also.
Thank you.
All right. So thank you very much for your presentation. Unfortunately, the time wasn't enough for you to keep on elaborating, but to the attendees, this conference, you'll be given certificates of attendance at the end of the conference, and then we will try to share the presentations and everything that you may need from the side. So yeah, I wanted to address that. The floor is yours, Professor Cornish.